I welcome you all students for today's science class. In today's class, we will be dealing with Unit 2, Force and Motion. Just think about the situation. Kavita can reach her school in two ways as shown in the picture. Can you tell by choosing which path she could reach the school early? This is another example. In the picture given here, you can see leaf falling from a tree. In which path the leaf will reach the ground first? So from the above examples, we could conclude that when an object travels from one place to another, it will reach faster if it travels along the straight line path. The straight line path is the shortest distance between two points. So in this lesson, we will be dealing with the following learning points: distance and displacement, speed and velocity, acceleration, distance time graph, and velocity time graph. Now we will see what is called distance and displacement. Distance: the total length of a path taken by an object to reach one place from another place is called distance. Displacement: the shortest distance from the initial position to the final position of an object is called displacement. Both distance and displacement possess the same unit. The SI unit of distance and displacement is meter. The motion of a person between two places A and B is given here. He travels 10 km along the first path. Along the second path, he travels 7 km. So the distance between A and B in case of the first path is 10 km and in the second path it is 7 km and in the third path it is 5 km. So the shortest distance between the two places is 5 km, which is represented by the third path. So the displacement is 5 km because the displacement is the shortest distance between the two places. So here the displacement is 5 km and it is in the east direction. The path of an object moving from point A to point B is shown. Total distance traveled by the object is 120 meter. The displacement of the object is 40 meter in southeast direction. Note: when we represent the displacement, we use a positive or negative sign depending on the direction in which it travels. When the object moves from a point A to B, the displacement is considered to be positive. When an object moves from a point B to A, the displacement is considered to be negative. Do you know nautical mile? Nautical mile is the unit for measuring the distance in the field of aviation and sea transportation. One nautical mile is 1.852 km. The unit for measuring the speed of aeroplanes and ships is knot. It means that they travel 1 nautical mile in 1 hour. Next, we will see what is called speed. Speed is the rate of change of distance. Speed is equal to distance by time. The unit of speed is meter per second. So, speed is classified into uniform speed and non-uniform speed. Under uniform speed, if a body in motion covers equal distance in equal intervals of time, then the body is said to be in uniform speed. So what is called non-uniform speed? If a body covers unequal distance in equal intervals of time, the body is said to be in non-uniform speed. So if you want to calculate average speed is equal to total distance traveled divided by time taken to travel the distance. Next, we will see what is called velocity. Velocity is the rate of change in displacement. So velocity is equal to displacement by time. The SI unit of velocity is meter per second. M by S. Uniform velocity. A body is said to have uniform velocity if it covers equal displacement at equal intervals of time in the same direction. Example, light travels through vacuum. Non-uniform velocity. It is just opposite to uniform velocity. If either speed or direction changes, the velocity is non-uniform. Example, a train starting and moving out of station. Average velocity. If the total displacement of an object is divided by the total time taken by the object, we get the average velocity. So average velocity is equal to total displacement divided by total time taken. Problems. An athlete takes 25 seconds to complete a 200 meter sprint event. Displacement is 50 meter. Find her speed and velocity. We have to find the speed and velocity. So we know the formula to find speed. Speed is equal to distance by time. So the distance is given to be 200 meter. So 200 divided by the time taken by the athlete is 25 seconds. So it is divided by 25. So 200 divided by 25 will be 8. And the unit of speed is meter per second. Next, we have to find the velocity. So velocity is equal to displacement by time. Displacement is 50 and time is 25. So 50 by 25 is equal to 2 meter per second. A car travels 5 kilometers due east and makes a U-turn to travel another 7 kilometers. If the time taken for the whole journey is 0.2 hours, calculate the average velocity of the car. So we have to calculate the average velocity of the car. So average velocity is equal to total displacement divided by total time taken. So taking the direction due east of point O as positive from the point O is 5 kilometer, then it takes a U-turn and travels another 7 kilometer. So average velocity is equal to total displacement by total time taken. The total time taken is 0.2 hours, and total displacement we have to subtract. 5 minus 7 divided by 0.2. so 5 minus 7 you will get minus 2 divided by 0.2, which is equal to minus 10 kilometer per hour. Converting kilometer per hour to meter per second, we have to multiply 5 by 18. So minus 10 into 5 by 18 meter per second, which will give you minus 0.28 meter per second. So the average velocity of the car is minus 0.28 meter per second. Relationship between velocity, displacement and time. So velocity is equal to displacement by time. Time is equal to displacement by velocity. Displacement is equal to velocity into time. So when you know the value for any two things, we can find the another. Suppose you know the value of velocity and displacement, you can find the time, or vice versa. Next, we will see what is called acceleration. The rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. In other words, if a body changes its speed or direction, then it is said to be accelerated. So if a body changes its speed or direction, then the body is said to be in acceleration. So acceleration is equal to change in velocity divided by time, which is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time. Final velocity is taken to be v, initial velocity is taken to be u, and time is taken to be t. So we have a is equal to v minus u by t. The SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Now we will do a problem. A car at rest starts to travel in a straight line path. It reaches a velocity of 12 meter per second in 4 seconds. What is its acceleration, assuming that it accelerates uniformly? So what will be the initial velocity of the car? The car starts at rest. So it will be 0 meter per second. So the final velocity will be 12 meter per second, and the time taken is given to be 4 seconds. So initial velocity u is equal to 0 meter per second, final velocity v is equal to 12 meter per second, and time taken t is equal to 4 seconds. We know the formula for acceleration. Acceleration is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time. So A is equal to V minus U by T. So V is 12, U is 0, and T is 4. Substitute the values. You will get A is equal to 3 meter per second square. The unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Now we will see what is called positive acceleration. If the velocity of an object increases with respect to time, then the object is said to be in positive acceleration. So if the velocity increases with respect to time, then it is said to be in positive acceleration. Here, the velocity of different times of a train departing direction is given in the figure. So if you see the distance traveled by the train from A to B is given. So it is at rest at point A. So it is 0 meter per second, the velocity, initial velocity, and the time taken is also 0 second. And when it reaches B, in 10 seconds it reaches, and the velocity is given to be 6 meter per second. And when it reaches C, the velocity is 14 meter per second, and the time taken to reach is 20 seconds. Likewise, it is given till F, point F. So initial velocity at point A is 0, and final velocity at point B is 6. So change in velocity is V minus U, so it is 6, and time taken will be 10. So we can find the acceleration. Similarly, we can find acceleration till point F, from A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, and E to F. So you have to complete this table by calculating the acceleration using the formula change in velocity by time. Next, we will see what is called negative acceleration. Negative acceleration is also called as deceleration or retardation. If the velocity of an object increases with respect to time, then the object is said to be in negative acceleration or deceleration or retardation. So negative acceleration is also called as deceleration or retardation. So when you consider this ball, okay, the velocity of a golf ball rolling in a straight line changes from 8 meter per second to 2 meter per second in 10 seconds. What is its deceleration? Assuming that it is decelerating uniformly. So here you can see within 10 seconds its velocity changes from 8 meter per second to 2 meter per second. That is, the velocity of an object decreases with respect to time. So the initial velocity u is equal to 8 meter per second and the final velocity v is equal to 2 meter per second. So the time taken t is equal to 10 seconds. So we know that acceleration is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity by t. So final velocity v is 2 and initial velocity u is 8 and the time taken is 10. So when you calculate, you will get acceleration is equal to minus 0.6 meter per second square. So the deceleration is minus 0.6 meter per second square. Next, we will see uniform acceleration. An object undergoes uniform acceleration when the change increase or decrease in its velocity for every unit of time is the same. So the table gives uniform acceleration of a bus. So when the velocity of the object is increasing by 20 meter per second, the acceleration will be 20 meter per second. When the velocity of the object is decreasing by 20 meter per second, then the deceleration is 20 meter per second. Non-uniform acceleration. An object undergoes non-uniform acceleration if the change in its velocity for every unit of time is not the same. When you look at the table, you can find the change in velocity is not the same every second. So it changes from 0, 10, 30, 20, 10 and 20. Thus, the moving object undergoes non-uniform acceleration. Distance-time graph. A car is traveling along a straight line away from the straight point O as shown here. The distance of the car is measured for every second. The distance and time are recorded and a graph is plotted using the data. The results for four possible journeys are shown. So when you look at this graph, first they have plotted for the car at rest. So the time is given in seconds and the distance in meter. From 0 to 5 seconds they have recorded and the distance is in 0 second. The distance traveled by the car is 0 and in 1 second it is 20 and in 2 seconds it is 20 and 3, 4, 5. In all the 3, 4, 5 seconds the car is in 20 meter. So this information they are plotting in the graph by taking x-axis as time and y-axis to be the distance. So the time is plotted here. In 0 second, the distance traveled by the car is 0. In 1 second, the distance traveled by the car is 20. So 20. And in 2 second also it is 20. 3 second it is 20. And 4 second is 20. And 5 second is also 20 meter. So, and the line can be drawn as shown here. The graph has zero gradient, the distance is a constant for every second. So every second, the distance is constant. Next is car traveling at uniform speed of 10 meter per second. So the time is given in second and the distance is given in meter. At 0 second, the distance traveled by the car is 0. At 1 second, the distance traveled by the car is 10 meter. In 2 second, the distance traveled by the car is 20 meter. And in 3 seconds, it is 30 meter. 4 second, it is 40 meter. And 5 second, it is 50 meter. So with the given information, a graph is plotted by taking x-axis to be time and y-axis to be the distance. Okay, and they are plotting the points. So at 0 second, the distance traveled is 0. And at 1 second, the distance traveled is 10. And 2, it is 20. And at 3 second, it is 30. And 4 second, it is 40. And 5 second, it is 50. And a straight line is drawn. So the graph has a zero constant gradient. The distance increases 10 meter every second. So every second the distance is increasing by 10 meters. The next is car traveling at increasing speed. The time and distance is given. So at 0 second the distance traveled by the car is 0. At 1 second the distance traveled is 5. At 2 second the distance traveled is 20. And at 3 seconds, the distance traveled by the car is 45. And at 4 seconds, the distance traveled by the car is 80. And at 5 seconds, the distance traveled by the car is 125. So a graph is plotted by taking time in the x-axis and distance in the y-axis. Okay? And the graph is plotted using the given information. So from the graph, we can see the graph has an increasing gradient. The speed increases. So the graph has an increasing gradient. The next is car traveling at decreasing speed. This is car traveling at increasing speed. This is car traveling at decreasing speed. So the data is given and the graph is plotted by taking time along x-axis and distance along y-axis. And as you can infer from the graph, the graph has a decreasing gradient. The speed decreases. Next, we will see speed time graphs. Let us consider a bus traveling from Tanjore to Trichy. So, a bus is traveling from Tanjore to Trichy. The speed of the bus is measured for every second. The speed and time are recorded and a graph is plotted using the data. It is known as the speed time graph. The results for four possible journeys are shown. So the first one is bus at rest. So at rest, the speed will be 0 and the time is given from 0 to 5 seconds and a graph is plotted by taking time along the x-axis and speed along the y-axis. So from 0 to 5 seconds, the speed is given to be 0. So the speed of the bus remains at 0 meter per second. So the bus has 0 acceleration. Bus traveling at uniform speed of meter per second. So the data is given here. The time is given in second and the speed is given in meter per second. So the time is given from 0 to 5 second and the speed is 10 meter per second from 0 to 5 second. The speed is constant throughout the time 0 to 5 second. And the graph is plotted by taking time along the x-axis and speed along the y-axis. The speed of the bus remains at 10 meter per second. Here, slope of the line is 0, so the bus has 0 acceleration. Next is bus traveling uniform acceleration. So, the time and speed is given. In 0 second, the speed is 10 meter per second. In 1 second, it is 10 meter per second. And in 2 second, it is 20. And 3 second, it is 30. 4 second, it is 40. And 5 second, the speed is 50. The graph is plotted by taking time along the x-axis and speed along the y-axis. The speed of the bus increases by 10 meter per second every second. Hence, the graph has a positive and constant gradient and the acceleration is constant. Bus traveling uniform deceleration. So, from 0 to 5 second, the time is given and the speed is, in 0 second, it is 50. In 1 second, the speed is 40. In 2 second, the speed is 30. And in 3 second, it is 20. In 4 second, it is 10. And in 5 second, it is 0. And the graph is plotted. The speed of the bus decreases by 10 meter per second every second. Hence, the graph has a negative and constant gradient and the acceleration is negative and constant. Next is bus traveling with increasing acceleration, non-uniform acceleration. The time is given from 0 to 5 seconds and the speed is also given and the graph is plotted. By taking time along the x-axis and speed along the y-axis. So, the speed of the bus increases with time. Hence, the graph has a positive and increasing gradient and the acceleration increases. As you can see here, the speed increases with time. So, the acceleration also increases. Bus traveling with decreasing acceleration, non-uniform acceleration. So, with the given data, the graph is plotted. The speed of the bus decreases with time. Hence, the graph has a positive and decreasing gradient and the acceleration decreases. As you can see here, with respect to time, the speed decreases. So, the acceleration also decreases. We learned about the distance time and speed time graphs, right? Now we will compare the distance time and the speed time graphs. Comparison between distance time and speed time graphs. The speed time graph and distance time graphs may look similar, but they give different information. We can differentiate them by looking at the table. So, here when you see, from A to B, car accelerates uniformly from rest. From B to C, car moves at constant speed. From C to D, car decelerates uniformly to a stop. The y-axis indicates distance, thus this is a distance time graph. Here the x-axis indicates the time and the y-axis indicates the distance. So we can say this is a distance time graph. So from A to B, car accelerates uniformly from rest. So distance moved increases at an increasing rate, hence gradient increases, represent by a concave curve. So from B to C, when you look here, car moves at constant speed. So distance moved increases uniformly over time, hence gradient is a position constant, represent by a Straight line. It is represented by a straight line. Here it is represented by a concave curve. From C to D, car decelerates uniformly to a stop. So it decreases. So distance moved increases at a decreasing rate. Hence, gradient decreases, represented by a convex curve. It is represented by a convex curve. So when you look at the speed time graph, the y-axis indicates the speed. So thus, this is a speed time graph. So from A to B, car accelerates uniformly from rest. Hence, speed increases uniformly over time. Hence, gradient is a positive constant represented by a straight line. Here it is represented by a straight line. Next, from B to C, car moves at constant speed. So speed is constant. Hence, the graph here is a horizontal line. It is a horizontal line. From C to D, car decelerates uniformly to a stop. So speed decreases uniformly over time. Hence, gradient is a negative constant represented by a straight line. So it decreases. So this is the difference between the distance time graph and the speed time graph. Summary of this lesson. So we learned about distance, the total length of a path taken by an object to reach one place from another place is called distance. Next, we learned what is called displacement, the shortest distance from the initial position to the final position of an object is called displacement. Next, velocity. Velocity is the rate of change in displacement. Velocity is equal to displacement by time. SI unit of velocity is meter per second. Next, we learned what is called acceleration. The rate of change of velocity is called as acceleration, and acceleration is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity by time. SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Next, we learned how to plot the distance time and speed time graphs, and we also learned the comparison between the distance time and speed time graphs. Thank you.